With Nags. In this video, we are going to see about how to verify your incremental refresh is working fine or not. You have configured the incremental refresh and deployed it in the Power BI services. And as we said before, it will create partitions for historical tables as well as for the current period or updates and new data. So how you can verify it, how you ensure how many partitions created or not, whether your incremental refresh is working fine or not. That is what we are going to check in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So what I meant here is, like, be aware of incremental refresh. That is, without incremental refresh, your table will directly create one partition. The table will create one partition here. In case of incremental refresh, a single table split into two categories. One is historical table and new updates. For historical, it will create some kind of partition based on the number of years you give. If you give 5 years, 5 partitions will be created. And for updates and new data, based on the frequency, you are given 3 days or 30 days or 7 days. Based on that, it will create different partitions. So finally, your data set will merge these two things. How you can verify it, right? Let's see, check it out in this video. So we are in Power BI service now, where we have deployed this data set, and go to settings, where you will configure these gateways, and you need to ensure the gateway is correct, and data source you will ensure it. Then you can do the schedule refresh. Now you can see the ref here, where it has failed for due to some reasons, and you can see the 1046 746, the data is completed here. I mean, the first refresh is completed. Then I have scheduled this refresh at 8 a.m. so when it is 8 a.m. the next refresh will start, right? So the next first refresh will refresh entire data set, the entire thing, the history and updates. The next data sets will update only the updates. How we will ensure it? So for that, I want to make you understand one concept, like each workspace considered as a server, right? We need to connect this workspace and to this data set, right, from Management Studio, and then you can be able to view these partitions created. So how you need to understand is, like, each workspace, you can see this is workspace considered as one server, this is another server. Inside this server, we have different data set. Each data set considers a database. You can have multiple databases here. So go to this workspace. And one more important thing is, like, you can able to connect to your workspace from Management Studio only if you have a premium capacity, right? So go to workspace settings, then click on premium, then you have this option, premium per user, where this is the URL to connect to your workspace from any client, right? Yeah, the client should support this connection. So from Management Studio, you connect to this workspace. This workspace acts as a server. So copy this URL, then go to the SSMS, then we will connect from there. So the pro or premium users can be able to configure the incremental refresh, but only using premium per user capacity, they can verify it, how the partition appears. That is the point. So this is not important to verify, because everything is handled by Microsoft Power BI services. But for you to understand the concept, how it actually behaves, I am using the capacity, I mean the opportunity we can have, right? Using a premium per user capacity, you can connect to the workspace from SSMS. You need to do, go to Management Studio, and you need to have a latest version of it. Click on analysis service and put your server name, each workspace, okay, your premium workspace, and use this Azure Active Directory. This option will appear only if you have a latest version of SSMS. I have 2018, so I have this one. So Azure Active Directory Universal MFA. Then click on the user. It will prompt you for some username and password. I have already mentioned it has appeared now. Now you can see here the database, right? Whatever you have deployed here will appear as a database in the management studio. Now you can go and check here the particular table, the whichever table you have deployed and partitions. So you can see now there will be a partition, different partitions appearing, and before for other data sets you will not have such a partition. Now you can see we have set 5 years of data for historical, so last 5 years you have some data, the partition created, and for the current year it will create for each quarter and for each date. And moreover, you can see all these partitions are processed on 7:47, and for currently I have scheduled around 8 o'clock. We'll wait for some time so that only the latest date, right, 10 days or 30 days data will get processed. For other partitions won't get processed. That is what we can see it here. So this is how you can verify whether your incremental refresh is working fine or not. Now you can go and check other tables which do not have any incremental refresh, like a supplier. In this you will have something like only one partition. So this is like only single partition table. Only for incremental tables you will get multiple partitions. Let us try to ensure whether this incremental process is happened or not. The next refresh is around 8 a.m. I hope it should be started. I'm not sure why it is not started yet. Let us see the timing here. Maybe it might be refreshed. See, now the refresh is started. Now we can see the in the SQL Server Management Studio, expand it, and we can see the partitions here. Once we see this, now you can see only for we have set the last 30 days data, so from 5/17 till the 18th, 4th of 18, the last 30 days data only processed. Other partitions are not processed for the previous year data. You can see it is untouched. Only the latest data for 30 days, how many days we have set, right? This configuration you might have remembered. Two configurations we have set, one for historical table, another for how many days you need to process. So next refresh onwards, only these 30 days keep on adding, and for each day when it comes, they have a data, there will be new partition created. So all these things are automated by Power BI. I hope you understand now how you can ensure it is working fine or not, the incremental refresh. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.